Doctor, I wanted to speak to you alone.
Miss Catherine wanted very much to see you again before you left.
I didn't want to take your place last summer. Please believe that, Aunt Vi. But Sebastian insisted. He said you weren't well enough to travel with him, and he couldn't travel alone, so he insisted that I go along with him in your place last summer.
And he died last summer.
Aunt Violet, would you like me to tell you?
You fell in love with Sebastian, didn't you, last summer?
I tried to give him what you had always given him, the tender understanding and the love you gave
My
him.
My son and I had a rare and wonderful love and trust between us. A sort of contract, a covenant between us.
Oh, I know.
He broke
it.
He broke that covenant between us when he broke away from me and took her, not me, to travel with him while he created his poem. Even when I was with him, even with me, he would sometimes be frightened, but I would know when and what of. I'd reach across the table to him and touch his hands. Say not a word, just look. And touch his hands with my hand. Then in the morning, the summer poem would be continued until it was finished.
I couldn't help him.
Naturally not. He was mine. I knew how to help him. I could. You didn't. You couldn't.
I tried.
I would say you will.
Oh, right. I failed him. I knew that the day we flew down to Gabetha de Lobo from where he'd given off writing his poem.
Because he had broken off.
Yes, something had broken. That string of pearls, old mothers.
Old?
Hold their sons by.
Yes, hold them from death.
No, life. Hold them from life.
What do you know? You were the stranger, the outsider, the destroyer. We were life.
You fed on life, both of you. Taking. People were objects for your pleasure. That's what you taught him, and he taught you. Oh, you were superior to mere mortals.
So we were. We needed no one but one another.
Sebastian only needed you while you were still useful.
Useful?
I mean young. Able to attract.
She's babbling again, babbling and lying.
He left her home because she had lost her...
Because you stole him.
Lost her attraction.
What would attraction have to do with a son and a mother?
I'll tell you.
Is there no way to stop these lies?
Yes. Have my brain cut.
Doctor, this was a mistake.
The mistake was my going with Sebastian. When he left her home, she had a stroke.
Not a stroke.
A hysterical stroke. Sebastian left her home like a toy he'd tired of. And he took me with him like a new toy on his last voyage.
Lies. All
lies. You
see,
Doctor, we both... We were decoys.
Decoys?
For Sebastian, he used us as bait. And when she was no longer able to lure the better fish into the net, he let her go.
Bait for what? What were the better fish?
We procured for him... She used to do it in the smart, fashionable places they went to before last summer. Sebastian was shy with people. She wasn't. Neither was I. But we both did the same thing for him. We both made contacts for him.
I can't listen to this obscenity. Stop her, Doctor.
Cut the truth out of my brain. Is that what you want, Aunt Vi? Well, you can't. Not even God can change the truth that we were nothing but a pair of...
Doctor!
It's the truth!
See how she destroys us with her tongue through a hatchet. You've got to cut this hideous story out of her brain.
How much are you willing to pay for that, Aunt Vi?
Get me away from her. Out of here. Out of this.
Nurse, some spirits of ammonia, please.
Yes, Doctor.